Hey, welcome to Life After My Stroke. Now, this might not be the most popular video I've ever done in this series, but it's stuff that's on my mind and I just wanted to get it out there. Now, when I go on the Stroke Survivors Facebook pages, I see a lot of people talk about recovery and rehabilitation and different methods that they've used or methods they're curious about to try to get back some of the stuff that they've lost. And that's great stuff to discuss. And we all want to improve, so it's great to share that information. I also see a lot of people talking about how things have changed in their lives, how relationships have changed in their lives. And it got me thinking, maybe some of the recovery that we should be talking about is the recovery here and here. That may be some of the hardest recovery that a lot of us face. You see, with me, I'm a positive guy. I'm very much a positive guy. But I will say this. I have no delusions about ever being 100% again. I understand that this may be what I've got for a while. So with that in mind, and knowing that I'm not going to live forever, I need to live my life right now. I need to do the things that I want to do right now, or I need to figure out how to do the things that I want to do right now and do them to the best of my ability. I have a confession to make. I won't watch a movie about handicapped people. I won't watch a movie about somebody who has cancer or lost their legs or whatever. I don't know why, but that kind of stuff just isn't my thing. I'm uncomfortable with it. Now, if I'm watching a movie and the person who invented this amazing thing happened to get cancer, that's okay. I just don't want to watch a movie specifically about someone's journey in cancer. It's not interesting to me, and it makes me uncomfortable for some reason. And my mother's the same way. When I was in the hospital, they kept trying to get me to read some book that the therapist found very motivating and uplifting and encouraging about someone who had had a stroke, and I should read it. And I said, no, I'm really not interested in that. Oh, well, you have a bad attitude. No, I don't have a bad attitude. I just don't like that kind of stuff. And then they asked my mother to read it, and she said, no, I'm not reading that. So it's just who we are. So the reason I'm bringing this up is because I think there are people who are like that. They'll watch a movie about the guy who invented the amazing thing and got cancer, but they won't watch a movie just about his cancer. Are we just about our strokes? I mean, how do we identify ourselves? Do we let the stroke identify us as people now? You know, if we do, we may have some problems with relationships because not everybody is going to want to deal with that. They've got their own lives to live. And I understand that. I mean, if I had became the poster boy for stroke after it had happened to me, then I think there would have been a lot of people who knew me who would have bailed because that's not me. That's not who I am. They wanted Brian. And you know what? They got Brian. My kid wanted me. My kid wanted daddy. My kid got daddy. My mother and father wanted their son. They got their son. So I really just wanted to bring that up. We need to be us. Yes, we've had things happen to us. I certainly had things happen to me. But here and here, I'm still the same guy. And I think that if we change, then we can't really be surprised when our friends and loved ones are uncomfortable with that or turned off by that, because that's certainly not what they signed up for. I mean, the physical thing, whatever. You gotta do what you gotta do. But here, in here, you gotta be you. And if you're not, if you're a different person now because of this, what do you expect? Can you really be too hard on these people? They're doing their best too. You have to do your best for them, for their sake and yours. That's my video for tonight. I hope it wasn't too heavy for some of you. Just wanted to get it out there. We'll see you next time, and please just keep pushing and hanging there.